Have you ever noticed that when you color correct or grade a 360 degree photo, that they often create a visible seam? Today, I'll show you how to use a free Photoshop script that'll allow you to batch edit your 360 photos so that you can apply that same color correction to them without that ugly seam line. Hi, I'm Rick Tan, and I'm going to show you how to use a Photoshop script that I've written that allows you to apply the most recent camera raw filter to all the photos in a folder without that ugly seam line. If you're in a rush and you don't need to know how the script works, just jump to this part of the video where I show you how to install and run the script. But if you want to know exactly how the script works, then keep watching. No self-respecting photographer would publish or attempt to sell a photo that comes straight off the camera with no color correction. But when I do a photo shoot, I've got dozens of images to process, most of them with the same color adjustments. So I had to come up with a way to edit them all seamlessly. I use my 360 shop to present and sell my 360 degree photos. And here, I've created a gallery where I'll add an unedited photo. It's taken at 0 EV, so we'll see that the parts in the sun are a bit overexposed. But because the subjects are in the shadows, the people are still a bit underexposed. I could have set a higher EV to overexpose the image, but then the sky would be too bright and I would have lost the detail in the clouds. So we'll go back. And edit this photo in Photoshop. And apply a camera raw filter because it gives us the most control, even with a JPEG. The first thing to do with a photo like this is to brighten the shadows so that the faces are no longer underexposed. The sunny sky is a bit overexposed, so we'll drag the highlight slider down to regain some of that cloud detail. I like to increase clarity and dehaze slightly, even though there isn't haze in this photo. It just adds edge contrast and sharpens the subjects. I'll bring up the overall exposure a touch, as well as the contrast. Now bringing the white level up will clip the highlights and lose some of the detail that we regained, but we can afford to do that. And it'll brighten the entire image. Finally, we drag down the black level, which will add intensity to the darkest shadows and really make the image pop. When we're happy with that, we click OK to apply the filter. I'm going to save this image now and add seam to the name because I know that this will have a visible seam. And hit enter to save. Now let's see how this looks in the viewer. You can see that the edited photo looks much better. The dancers' faces are nicely lit without the background being overexposed. But when we go to the seam, previously there was no visible line. But in the edited version, there's a distinct line running down this poor girl's face and her legs. That's just unacceptable. Let's go back to Photoshop. When you edit the colors in a photo, most image editors, including Photoshop, will look at the neighboring pixels in order to determine the relative changes that should be made to each pixel. The thing about a 360 degree photo is that the relative changes should be based on the pixels that continue on the other side of the image. In other words, the other side of this join line or seam. But these programs currently don't. So you're left with an edited image, which looks fine, until you view it in a 360 viewer. Then you see the difference between left and right side of the seam. There's a free app by Stefan Baum that addresses this, and it's called Anti-Seam 360. It's great, but the workflow requires you to do a pre-color correct process. You color correct, and then apply the post-color correct process. It's also limited to one file at a time, and only works on Android. Inspired by Stefan's app, I've created a Photoshop script which I've called Seamless 360 Edits. This is the first Photoshop script I've ever written. It works well for me, and I hope it works well for you too. Here's how it works. Let's take the original unedited photo. The script will duplicate the background layer, Ctrl-J or Command-J, and then widen the canvas size. This is a shot off the Xiaomi Mi Sphere. With this particular photo, widening the canvas by 100 pixels is enough. But experimenting with different photos, I found that the seam was still there until I increased the canvas width by 6,000 pixels. So we'll make it 12,912 pixels wide. Then we duplicate this layer twice. We'll rename the duplicates right and left. Zoom out a bit and hide the background layer. Next, the right layer gets moved to the right so that it joins the right edge of the photo. And then the left layer gets moved to the left and snaps to the left edge of the photo. I'll just rename layer 1, Orange, so that you can see what the original image looks like. Then I'll duplicate it, Ctrl-J or Command-J. Shift-click to select the top three layers and merge them, Ctrl-E or Command-E. We'll hide the original and rename the wider one, Expanded. Now we'll apply the Camera Raw filter. If we choose the top option, it'll apply the filter with the previously used settings. The Photoshop script doesn't use the original layer, but I've created this so that you can see the difference. I'll drag the original to the top and unhide it. And I'll apply the same filter to it. Now you can see that it's different from the expanded one. Zooming in, you can see a bit of the seam. It's not as pronounced because it joins with the expanded one instead of the other side of the image. But you can tell that it's different from what it should be. We don't need that layer, so we'll delete it. Hit delete on a full-size keyboard. At this point, the script restores the canvas to its original size. So we'll go to Image, Canvas Size, and set the width back to 6912. And proceed to clip the sides off. Merge down to remove the original background, Ctrl-E or Command-E. And we'll save this as Seamless. Upload it to our gallery. Click Sort or Delete Photos. We'll bring this most recent one to the bottom and delete the unedited version and save changes. Now let's see how it looks. Let's go to that seam line in both photos. Here's the one with the visible seam, and here's the one without. So how do we automate this so that we don't have to manually do all of that for every photo in our photo shoot? We use Seamless 360 Edit, the Photoshop script that I've written. After you download it from the URL below, my360shop.com/seamless360edit, just unzip it and place the .jsx file in your presets scripts folder. Here are the locations for Windows and for Mac. Now we're going to apply the edits to all the photos in the dance folder. So I'll just delete the two that we created for this demo. Now we'll go back to Photoshop, close this earlier example, and if you've added the script to your scripts folder with Photoshop open, then you'll need to restart Photoshop. Once the script has been added, just go to File, Scripts, and seamless 360 edit. You'll then be asked to choose the folder that contains the 360 photos to be edited. Select the folder and click Select Folder. Photoshop will now open each of the 360 photos in that folder. The script supports JPEG, TIFF, and DNG RAW files, and it'll apply the most recent filter seamlessly. My graphics card isn't fast enough to show you the photos as they're being processed, but you get the idea. Let's go back to our gallery and delete the test photos. Now in our folder, you'll see that the edited versions have done appended to the start of the file names. I've written that into the script so that they're easy to find and the originals remain untouched. Let's add all the done ones to the gallery. Once they've uploaded, click Update and view the gallery. Let's pick a random page. And you can see that all of these are beautifully color corrected without a visible seam anywhere. Let's check another page. Even with different costume colors, the dancers all look great, and there's no seam anywhere. Let's quickly check that this script works with shots from a different camera. Here's a folder with shots from an Insta360 ONE X. The photo dimensions are a bit different from the Mesphere. Let's see if the script can handle it. I'll speed up these adjustments. They're similar to the other photo shoot, but it was a cloudy day, so the original colors were really flat, and we have to intensify the adjustments a bit. Let's check the before and after. It's like night and day. Click OK. Now that we're happy with the edit, close the file. And don't save the changes, because we're going to apply the edit to all the photos from this shoot. Choose our script. Select the folder. Click Select Folder. And let the script do its magic. Now let's go back to my 360 shop and create a public gallery. Call it Capoeira. Set a price for each photo and choose your currency. Add a description and some tags. We'll let people view in full screen before they purchase and save the gallery. Now we'll add the photos. And update the gallery. And now we have a gallery of color graded 360 degree photos, and none of them have a visible seam. I hope that this script is as useful for you as it is for me. It's provided for free, as is, with no warranties. As with all edits, make sure you have a backup of all of your photos before you start. And happy editing your 360 photos seamlessly.